Hey, it's Andrew here from andrewhubbard.co, and in this video we're going to talk about how to get a Facebook ad account back once it's been shut down. So this can be one of the most stressful things that happens to a business. You're running Facebook ads, they're doing well, and then all of a sudden you get that dreaded email that says your Facebook ad has been shut down by Facebook and you're literally dead in the water, can't do anything at all. So the good news is you can actually get these accounts back. Not always, this isn't a guarantee, but we've had it happen. It happens to the best of us. We rarely have problems in our ad agency. We're very, very white hat, but sometimes it still happens. And we're going to show you right now in this video the things that we do that give us the highest success rate in terms of getting our ad accounts back. So first thing I want to start by mentioning before we jump into the content here is I am creating this video for people who are very much on the white hat side. They want to be compliant with policy. They want to run ads for legitimate businesses, for legitimate companies, and they want to follow Facebook's policy. That's what I'm all about. That's what our company is all about. We're very much about following Facebook's policy, about, you know, it's their sandbox. We want to play within their rules and do everything we can to follow policy and be compliant and to create a great experience with our ads for the end users on Facebook and Instagram. Okay, if you're trying to do things that are shady, sketchy, if you're trying to run products that aren't meant to be run on Facebook, that they don't want run, anything like that, that where you're trying to push the rules or push the boundaries, this video is not for you. Okay, this video is for people who want to be compliant, who want to follow Facebook's rules, and who want to really succeed and grow on the Facebook platform with their ads while being compliant with policy. All right, so that said, let's jump in and talk about what to do step by step. There's four real steps to this process. And I'm actually going to show you at the end of this video, I'll walk you through an example of what we can write in our appeal and that has had a high level of success for us. So let's start with first things first. Okay, the first thing you want to do is go and complete Facebook's blueprint training on compliance. Okay, Facebook have a specific training on this, on ad policy and compliance. Go through and do the blueprint training. The reason for this is because one of the first things they say when they send you that email that says your ad account has been shut down, they say we recommend going and completing the blueprint training to understand why. So go and complete that training. Now what this does, it shows Facebook that you're actually putting in an effort, you're actually making a concerted effort to be compliant, to do the right thing. You show that you're making an effort to address this problem, and yes, okay, saying look, If this was an ad that wasn't compliant that caused our ad account to get shut down, we're taking steps to go and educate ourselves. We're taking steps to make sure this doesn't happen again. So go and complete the blueprint training. It takes less than an hour to do and get it done and certified. Go and do that first. Okay, step one, it's easy. If you can't even be bothered doing that, then let's be honest, they're probably going to look at that and say, well, you know what? This person isn't serious about following our policy. We're not going to reactivate this account. So go and do that first. Second thing is go into the ad account and see if you can identify why the account was disabled. Okay. Understanding what may have triggered the disapproval will shape the appeal letter that you write, and it will help to inform that letter, and it will help you show them that, hey, okay, I have gone through the account. I've made an effort to understand why this happened. And then you can kind of frame your appeal around that. Okay, so if you can go to Facebook and say, look, I understand that the account may have been disabled because of X, Y, and Z, let's say because we had an ad disapproved that in Facebook's opinion was false or misleading, then you can go and say, look, I understand it may be because of that. However, I think this may have been a mistake because if you read through the ad, we don't actually make any promises. We're very clear in stating that not everybody will get this result, and we're just showing a case study. Whatever it is, if you can go and demonstrate that you understand why it may have occurred and then sort of explain to them why you think that may actually be compliant, then that gives you a stronger argument for having the ad account re-enabled. Okay, so let's just talk about the third thing now. Third thing is just go through and clean out the account. If there is anything in there that you think may be borderline, maybe non-compliant, go ahead and delete it. There's no point leaving it in there. What this shows is that in case they restart the account, you're cleaning out anything that may be non-compliant. You're just starting with a nice clean slate. Anything that's even borderline, you remove it, and it shows that you're actively making moves there to get rid of anything in the account that may be a reason for disapproval. Now, let's go over and see that step number four is you actually submit your appeal to Facebook. And I'll put a link in the comments below so you can link to that form where you can go and appeal the disapproval. But you want to go in and submit an appeal to Facebook. I'm about to show you a walkthrough of a sample letter that we can send off. What I ask you to do is don't copy this. It's something that needs to be personalized. You can't copy and paste this. If we start seeing people copy and paste this stuff, then it won't work, because it's a small team of people that review these appeals. And if they start seeing exactly the same thing, copy and paste it over and over again, they're just going to see it, go, oh, this is the same, copy and paste, reject. Okay? So it actually doesn't serve you to copy and paste this. You'll get a worse result if you copy and paste this than if you just go and write your own letter. Okay? I'll walk you through the structure of this now, and you can go and do that and submit that appeal. The first thing I will say is you will notice when you look at this letter that it is very positive, and it's not this negative like, oh, Facebook sucks, you know, you shouldn't have rejected our account, you know, this is rubbish. If you go at it with a negative approach like that, they won't even finish reading the letter and you've got no chance of getting your account back. Okay, you need to come at this from a positive, apologetic, understanding perspective. You're talking to real human beings. You need to be polite. Okay, it feels weird that I need to explain this, but being polite, approaching this in a conversational way, and just being courteous to the person reading this will get you a much better result than if you come at it from an aggressive, upset approach. Okay. So let's jump over now. Let's go through the letter together and you can understand exactly how to submit an appeal. All right. So you can see here, I've put together a letter here. We're going to walk through it together. Let me make it a bit larger for you. Okay. So first thing here, what we're doing is when we open here, we're saying, please allow me to start by apologizing for any alleged breach of Facebook advertising policy. Our intent is to always be 100% compliant and respectful of policy. So any breach that may have occurred is certainly unintentional, and I apologize unreservedly for that. What we're doing here is we're starting by apologizing, okay? We're not starting it with an aggressive tone saying, hey, you should re-enable our account. We're actually saying, look, I'm sorry if we did do something to break the rules, okay? Then we're saying the alleged breach. We're not admitting to any breach here. We're just saying, look, it's an alleged breach. Obviously, Facebook thinks something is wrong. It's alleged that we've broken policy, so we apologize for that, okay? Then we're just stating that we do want to be compliant and respectful of policy, okay? So we're just saying there that, look, our intent is always to be a good advertiser. We want to be a good actor on the platform, okay? Very clear. We're coming at this from an apologetic perspective. What we're doing in the second paragraph is we're saying, my team and I manage a large number of advertising accounts for our agency, and I also train advertisers and speak on large stages around the world on the topic of Facebook advertising. So I'm just adding a little bit of credibility. I'm saying, look, we run a lot of accounts. We're not just a fly-by-night, you know, pop-up, dodgy advertiser who's trying to, you know, get around the rules to make a quick buck. Okay, we're legitimate. We're a big agency. You know, we're really trying to work with Facebook to grow businesses here. And then, you know, we're just saying, so I'm constantly revising ad policy to ensure I have an excellent understanding of it and can advise and educate others on the importance of maintaining compliance at all times. So I'm saying, look, I'm adding some credibility here, and I'm saying, yeah, because I'm teaching on this, because I'm running so many accounts, I'm always reviewing policy. And my perspective is always to teach others the importance of compliance, because that's true, right? I said that earlier in this video. I'm all about working within the rules that Facebook set out when working as an advertiser on the platform. I'm working with Facebook here. This is their platform. I totally respect that. And when I do go out and teach people, I always teach people to work within the rules of Facebook to provide a great user experience. It gets you better results and it keeps you compliant with Facebook. Okay, so definitely that's a perspective we want to take, and we're just communicating that here with the reviewer. Remember, this is a real person. Their job is to keep bad actors off the platform, to make sure that accounts that are meant to be disabled stay disabled, and that accounts that should be active are active. And you want to just demonstrate to them that, hey, this is actually an account that should be active, and maybe it was disabled because of an automated system or whatever that is. And you wanted to say, look, I understand how it is important for us as advertisers to provide a positive experience at all times to Facebook's users on the platform, because that's what Facebook wants. They want to provide a positive experience. It's why they don't allow certain ads. It's why they have the policies they have. And it's why they disable ad accounts, because if we're not providing a positive experience as advertisers for the users of the platform, they're going to shut us down. So we need to provide a positive experience. We need to demonstrate to Facebook that we understand that that's their intent. They want to make sure that advertisers are providing a positive experience to the users of their platform, because the users are the most important thing on that platform. So in the third paragraph, we're saying, to further emphasize the high priority we put on compliance as a company, I've also completed and successfully passed the Facebook Blueprint module on ad policy and compliance, and it's our company policy for all team members to do so as well. Again, this is true. We're just emphasizing that, look, we actually make a concerted effort to understand and be compliant with policy. And this is how we demonstrate that. We go through the training that you, Facebook, provide us. And we follow that and we attempt to apply that at all times. Okay. And again, this is true. Go through, like, I've been through Blueprint, team's been through Blueprint to be compliant. So then you'd say, look, I've actually gone through the accounts. We're saying, after going back through the ad account and carefully looking over each ad, I'm struggling to see which policy we violated. Okay, we're promoting a service, and this is for our specific case. We're promoting a service which is completely within Facebook's terms of service and ad policy, and it's from a company with an excellent reputation and a strong history of delivering an exceptional level of service to its customers. And that applies to the case in which this is used, right? So you want to demonstrate that, look, what we're promoting is legitimate. It's, you know, got a very happy customer base. You know, we don't get any complaints. We're actually a really legitimate, well-known company, all those kind of things. You want to like some pop-up affiliate that's trying to run like dodgy traffic. You know, you want to demonstrate that what we're selling is actually something that people want, provides a good experience for our customers. And we do, you know, we are an established company. Then we're saying, look, our reason, after analyzing our ads, I noticed that, you know, we'd been rejected for an ad that said it might be false or misleading claims. So I addressed that in the next paragraph. I said, look, in our ad creatives and copy, we're very careful not to promise or imply that a user will get a specific result or benefit. Most of what we're promoting on directly on Facebook is case studies and examples from past students. There's a bit of a typo there. Where we are sharing their results, but being very careful not to promise or imply the same result for readers. And if you read through our ad copy that we were using here, we actually said in there, look, you know, this is the case study, this is the result that this person got, but this does not mean or imply that you'll get the same result. What we're doing is just showing you what happened for them. We actually say that in the ad, like we're saying, look, you know, it doesn't mean you're going to get the same result, but this is, you know, this is what happened for them. Then we're saying here, we're just trying to connect in the next paragraph and just demonstrate like that it's a real company with real employees, and having this account shut down has real impacts, and just asking for a little bit of empathy, I guess, and understanding from the reviewer. They are a human being, and this is all actual honest stuff. We're not, I guess what I need to emphasize here is you got to be honest, right? Don't lie. If there's any lying in this or any kind of deceit, these people read reviews and appeals. They read appeals all day long. They deal with unhappy people all day long. You got to remember that. And honesty is always the best approach. So look, we're saying here, the company that owns the ad account in question relies heavily on Facebook advertising as a source of high quality traffic. And having the ad account shut down has a deep impact on the business that flows all the way down to their employees and the families of those employees. So we're just emphasizing, look, this, you know, having Facebook as an advertising partner for this business and using it as our primary advertising platform is really important. And it actually is having a profound, you know, effect on the company while we're shut down, and trying to get the reviewer to understand that. Now we're just saying, look, again, we're taking a very passive approach here. We're not being aggressive. In the next paragraph, we say, I know you're just doing your job. Most likely have to deal with hundreds of non-compliant accounts each week looking to get reinstated. So we're saying, look, we know you got to deal with this all the time. And we know that most of these appeals that you read are probably dodgy accounts trying to get reinstated, but we're not one of them. And I'm just saying here, I hope you're able to recognize that we're doing everything we can to be responsible advertisers on Facebook. And for what it's worth, after honestly reviewing the ads in the account, I really do believe it to be in compliant with policy. Gacy's just saying, look, I know you see a lot of dodgy stuff on here, a lot of shady stuff, but, you know, this is a legit business. After reviewing our account and understanding policy, going through Blueprint, I really do believe that, you know, this is compliant and this account should be reinstated. And then just saying, like, simply, look, being polite, I would like to thank you for taking the time to consider this appeal and for the work you do. Okay, just saying thanks doesn't hurt. Just being a good person. And then I hope you're able to reconsider the decision and reactivate the account for us. If you do, I can assure you that we'll continue to do everything possible to be compliant with policy and create an extremely positive experience for Facebook's users with our advertising. All right. Again, we're just reiterating that we understand what they want. They want positive experience for the users. And just reiterating that, hey, look, we're asking you to reactivate the account for us. And that if you do, you know, we'll continue to be good actors on the platform. Okay, simple as that. Now, submit your appeal and then just wait for a response. Don't submit a new appeal every day, because what that does is it just puts you back at the bottom of the queue. Submit the appeal, wait for a response, okay? Hopefully, what this will do is get your ad account reinstated and you'll be back up and running. If it doesn't, you can submit multiple appeals. So if you get rejected, try resubmitting a new appeal, maybe reword it, maybe change it around a little bit. Give some more context, give some more information. But doing something like this, going through the process I just showed you, gives you a much, much greater chance of getting your ad account reinstated than if you go at it with an aggressive frame of mind and say, oh, you know, this is wrong, you can't do this to our business, blah, blah, blah. If you approach it like that, you've got no chance of getting your account back. Same as if you go in and just give very little information, like, hi, I think this account was shut down in error, please review. That's not going to get it back either, unless, you know, it's a massive mistake on Facebook's part. This approach will give you the best chance possible. So if you do have your ad account shut down and you're legit and you really are compliant with policy, follow these steps. I really hope you get your ad account shut down, because I do know how stressful it can be. But again, you know, it's Facebook's sandbox, Facebook's rules. And the only way we can succeed on the platform is if we do everything possible to follow that policy. All right, I hope this video has helped you. If it has, please drop me a comment and tell me how. And don't forget, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell to make sure you don't miss another video from me. I'll always be releasing new content on a very regular basis, sharing around Facebook advertising, Instagram advertising, sales funnels, and all things online traffic. So hit subscribe and I'll see you in the next video.